What's up, guys, and welcome back to Flare Reviews. Tonight, we start our journey into made-for-streaming service Christmas movies. Some are really bad, some are okay, some are just awful. Tonight, we start with The Noel Diary. Came out this year, 2022. It's gonna run you a tight 99 minutes. It's a comedy, drama, romance. It is directed by Charles Shire, starring Justin Hartley, Bonnie Bedelia, and James Remar. So this is a story about a very famous writer who is estranged from his mother, gets the phone call his mother has passed. She's left him the house, his childhood home. He has to go back to the home and clean it out. And while he's there, a stranger approaches him at the house and tells him that he is his old nanny's daughter. And she's basically been searching for her mom her entire life, her birth mother. And so it takes some convincing because they find out that Jake's dad would know who the mom is, who the nanny is, where she is, what she's been doing. And so we go on this journey with Jake and then his co-writer. I forgot to write her name down. I apologize, the character's name. And basically they slowly fall in love. And they find a diary written by her mother, which tells about her life as a 17-year-old nanny who was pregnant. And basically, it's called The Noel Diary. And so they slowly fall in love, even though his co-writer is engaged to another man. He knows that. She doesn't really know he's a famous author until like halfway through the movie. And so there's a lot of like meet-cute moments, little very rom-com just moments in general. It's pretty much you would expect it to be. There's that little thing in the way, you know, our main character doesn't ever want to be in love. He likes to be alone. He's used to being alone. Meets this beautiful, sophisticated woman. She's trying to find answers about her past. They cross paths by chance, and they accidentally fall in love unbeknownst to each other. So overall, it's okay. it's a made for streaming service movie, and that's what we're here for. I'm gonna watch all these bad movies just for you guys. So we're gonna start this one off with like a 5.4 out of 10. So hopefully they improve from here, but chances are unlikely because every year the streaming service Netflix movies get worse and worse. And I will talk to y'all next time here at Flare Reviews.